This question is from Industrial Management and Operations Research for 2 marks. The project consists of 6 activities. The immediate predecessor of each activity and the estimated duration is also provided in the table below. So we have 6 activities and their immediate predecessors. We are also given with the duration of each activity in weeks. If all the activities other than S take the estimated amount of time, the maximum duration in weeks of the activity S without delaying the completion of the project is. So for this question, the accepted answer range is 6 to 6. So coming back to the solution, in order to solve this kind of things where we are given with few activities and their immediate predecessors and duration, the first step is to draw the network diagram. When we do so, the network diagram for this particular question, we get the network diagram in this way. Or once the network diagram is completed, the next step is to calculate the critical path. For that, let us try to note down what are the possibilities for the project to complete. The first possibility is through the activities P, T and U. So calculating the total duration, that is 5 for activity P, 6 for activity T and 3 for activity U. The total duration will be 14 weeks. Coming to the second possibility, we have P, dummy, S and U. So by taking that path, we get the project completion duration to be 12 weeks. The next and last possibility for the project completion is Q, R, S and U. That will be the third path. Calculating the project duration along this path, we get 10 weeks. Now among these three possible paths, the path with highest project duration is 14 weeks, that is P, T and U. Hence, that will be considered as a critical path. So to differentiate the critical path from the other paths, the critical path on the network diagram will be drawn with a double arrow line, this way. Now that we have the critical path as P, T, U with project completion duration as 14 weeks, the next step is to calculate the total float on activity S. Total float on activity S is 11 minus 5 minus activity duration, that is 4. So doing that will give us the total float on activity S as 2. Now the maximum duration of activity S without delaying the project completion is nothing but total float on activity S plus duration of activity S. So since we have the total float on activity S as 2, duration of activity S is already given in the question as 4. Therefore, the maximum duration of activity S without delaying the project completion is 6 weeks.